The software defined radio technology is something we've been working on for the entire lifetime of the company. One of the things we realized very early on was that if we were going to get to true economies of scale with these satellites, each one needed to be identical in hardware to the other satellites. And the only way to do that is with a software defined radio. Now you can build each satellite the same as the one that came before and do those configurations on orbit. And that means we can actually reuse the satellites for new missions, we can relocate them, and we can deploy updates to the software-defined radio over the air, making those changes on orbit on the fly. We flew our first software-defined radio on our demo satellite. Then last year, we flew an upgraded version on Arcturus that is operating successfully on orbit today. And now we're flying an even more advanced version with these new Block 2 satellites.
A couple of things really went into going from our Arcturus SDR to our Block 2 ones. First one was we increased our bandwidth, our throughput that we could use.
This enables stronger DSP algorithms and more throughput through the same volume of hardware.
And the second one is that this SDR is actually fully redundant. Basically got two sides of it.
When you look inside of here, there's actually two complete copies of hardware. So any component can fail anywhere in this box, you will still have a fully functioning radio. You have zero degradation to throughput, to coverage. We had to get clever to make everything work within the same volume, weight, power, footprint, while doubling the resources. And also 20% mass reduction. So that's what we've been working on for the last 2 years.